What is going on, collectors? Optical 20 back for another video preview. Today, we're going to take a look at 11, or Ellie, from Stranger Things, from 3-0. And you can pre-order this figure at BigBadToyStore.com. I'll put the link down below. It's $4 shipping, and you can put it on your pile of loot. So, you know, if you change your mind within 90 days, you can cancel her, because I am still not sold on this Ellie. I do love Stranger Things, though. I do love Stranger Things. I saw the Demogorgon figure from 3-0, and it's a bit expensive for me at $250. I would love to have it. I think it's pretty cool. However, the price kind of turned me off, and not in general, not for 1/6, because I know $250 is kind of like, as a matter of fact, I think it's $270 now, which is the norm for 1/6. And Demogorgon might be bigger. It's a unique body and look. But I feel like from 3-0 standpoint, they can price Rambo for $200. Why not the same for Demogorgon? Now, 11 is not bad pricing-wise. It's kind of in line to what they are. It's one for $170. So it's a bit high. It's kind of like in the Jamie Lannister category. And this is, I'm talking about 3-0's standards here, right? There's a few things that kind of bothered me about this figure. The head sculpt is not bad. I think it has a pretty good likeness. Now, the paint application on the hair especially could be a little better, in my opinion. They could have used a little more angry expression. Or maybe, I feel like the expression between the bleeding nose and the non is close enough. You know, that's the only determining factor. At least maybe this make this angry. Or the bleeding nose should be a little bit more angry. Not screaming type of angry, but, you know, different enough. This one, you know, she's holding an ego, which is pretty cool. Now, a few things that I didn't like that stood out to me is the outfit, first and foremost. Let's start with the obvious, the wrist pegs. Pretty big, right? They could have made, again, I've said this before in some of their figures, they could have made the hands a little bit wider on the wrist area. So not a whole lot of those wrist pegs is showing. Some would show, but not this pronounced. Second, this hospital gown, is this a hospital gown or whatever? It doesn't fit her quite nicely. You know, maybe the material that was used is too stiff. I don't know what the case is. You see those hands that I was talking about. They should have done an Ellie here, in my opinion, where just swappable arms, because they went to the route where it's seamless arms, which is cool if you're going to display her in that look. What if you're going to display her in this look right here? Those seamless arms are going to deteriorate over time. And when you are not exposing the arms, I think it's better to have jointed arms, you know, for longevity. I don't know. I'm not a big fan of that look. Or swappable arms, which is the norm now. Well, not the norm, but they have the arms, the hands are attached, so it's seamless from the wrist to the hands. Some company, I think it's the Japan Musashi or whatever, that they have they change the forearms. Now, you're not going to change the forearm for this lady because, you know, but from that angle, from that look, do you really need to change hands all that much? I think this is pretty much the look that you're going to go for. So you can just, you know, make the hands fixed into the arm and give that seamless look without the, because in here you can kind of hide the ball joint with a watch. Not on the other hand, though, but you could. So those are the only two things that's kind of like bothering me here. Swappable arms, would that really cost that much? Maybe add another $10 or $20. I'd rather have that. Or just have jointed arms at all. Like, how many people are really going to display her in that hospital gown look? Like, most of us are probably going to... This is her preferred look. This is her iconic look. And by tailoring your entire figure based off one look, I just feel like that arms is gonna degrade so bad over time if you leave her in a certain pose. And I mean, the knees are the knees, I suppose. You know, you see the jointed knees in there. I don't know. For $170, I just feel like I don't know. I feel like this is okay, I put her in the same category. She got two head sculpt and a bunch of outfit, but she doesn't have the gimmick. Like, she's smaller as well. She's 9 inches tall. Obviously, she's a child in the show. But now I'm kind of comparing her to her contemporaries, which is Gollum. And you can make an argument that has a different body. It doesn't have the same accessories that she does have. But that also has a unique head sculpt. The eyes move around as well. If I had to choose, I'd rather choose that. Just because I feel like that's so unique. This one looks like any other 1/6, but smaller. But I just don't like some of the things. Like, that has swappable arms, you know, and I believe legs. Not arms, maybe legs. He has swappable legs, and he is priced at $120. So this is almost $50 more. Do we really need, the Ego? Maybe the Ego is a pretty vital. But yeah, I guess they could have priced this $10 more and give us swappable arms. Or just the jointed arms. Like, this look is cool, but to base the entire figure off of that one look, I don't know. But, some people, they might not bend the elbows all that much, because all the poses that we've seen her is either her arms are on the side, which doesn't require the elbows to be bent, or her arms are forward. Outside of she's eating Ego, you got to bend the arms there. But yeah, that is it. I should be sponsored by Ego by doing this this preview. Ego, holler at me, man. So, but yeah, I mean, it still looks decent. For $170, it's not bad. Am I going to pick this up? I might. Who am I kidding? I might. I mean, nowadays, 170 is like this pose right here. You can't leave her in this pose for too long, because otherwise you're compromising the elbows, you know. So you got two Egos, you got the watch, you got a variety of hands. Yeah, she got like the Vader choking hands in there, the Ego holding hand. So, I mean, if you got like figures with SWAT outfits on them, I got like Commissioner Gordon. That would be a good complimentary pieces to her. I guess the other question is, who else are we going to see within this line? I'm interested to find out who else in the Stranger Things category we're going to see moving forward from 3-0. You know, because we got the Demogorgon and now this. Who knows? So, but yeah, thank you for watching, guys. Hopefully you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up. You know, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so. Follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitch. And I will see you guys in the next video.